Okay, everybody, this is part two. He was dropping too much fire, and I had to get him on another call. So I twisted his arm, and we're back again. So let's talk about guts in action here. Let's talk about give a good phone in action. Can you show me, maybe do a role play or something? And what do you think?
Sure. It really depends on how your market. Most of your listeners are in real estate, correct?
Yeah, these are all real estate investors primarily, yes.
Okay. Most people in real estate have had no training in the art and science of persuasion.
I agree.
That million-dollar skill we were talking about in episode one here.
Yeah.
You've got to learn what empathy, what are they thinking? What are they feeling? If you approach people with the same old tired script, how many seconds do you think it takes for someone to get an idea in their head? What do you think happens? Rufus, I call you up at dinner. You got your meatloaf, hot meatloaf dinner there on your table. And I call you up and you ring, ring.
Yeah. Hi. Hello.
Hi there, Mr. Rufus. Claude Diamond here from ABC International Worldwide Investments. And I'd like to talk to you about real estate tonight. Do you have a moment? Can I have a moment of your time?
Click. That's it. Yes. 100%.
And this is a form of the way most people call.
Right.
Okay. Scripts are caca. If there's one, scripts are shit. Because in the first, how many seconds, what was going through your mind in the first 3-4 seconds that I opened up in that little.
Who is this guy and when can I get him off the phone so I can finish my meatloaf?
Yeah. You didn't ask, back to marketing. You didn't ask me to call. I interrupted your dinner and I sounded like a jerk on the phone, or right. I sounded like the other five people who called you about your home that's advertised in Zillow or the MLS or Craigslist.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly.
And here is where success is sucked out of the universe. You're doing that. What's the definition of insanity?
Doing the same thing over and over again. Yeah. Yeah. That doesn't work and expecting it to be better.
There's so many good people out there. All they want to do is pay their bills, put mac and cheese or meatloaf on the table.
Right.
And they're studying hard and they're spending a lot of money and nobody is teaching.
Right.
In the creative real estate market, nobody is teaching the things you and I are talking about in these episodes.
The art and
persuasion of getting another person to like you, trust you, and share information and make a commitment in one phone call. This is the million-dollar skill.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Yeah.
And I invite anybody, you can do all the marketing, you can hire all the people, you can build your team, you can do all this stuff. But in the end, how do you make money today, Rufus?
You got to talk to a person and buy their house and close the deal. I mean, that's human to human contact.
Amen, brother. Amen. Yes. So why are you doing the same old tired script, getting 99 to 100% reject? What happens to us when we get all this rejection? What happens, honestly?
You get worn down. You lose your confidence and you stop moving forward. You stop believing you can do it. And then you
I get out my boohoo tissues, man. It's like, I'm going to go clean the toilet or something. Yeah. I don't want to touch that phone as a cactus now.
That's
okay.
Right.
I don't want to touch it. Okay. And this is where this is the slippery slope downhill. And then they go to the next guru with the next little shiny object. Oh, John and Mary made money with our great little system here. And you don't have to do anything. You can go to sleep and make money. And that's all bullshit.
Right.
Okay. I'm telling too much truth again. I'm sorry.
No, I love it. I love it.
And so this is the death of nobody. Most of the information resources out there are about 50 to 85% motivation.
Gotcha.
You can do it. Walk into the sunshine. And if 100 people say no, you knock on another 100 doors and you go out there. This is your test. And they're making it like it's your character issue. Like you don't have the tenacity to go out there and knock on doors. I'll be honest. I can't take out that much rejection. I cry at Disney movies. I'm sensitive. Okay.
We all do. We all do. That's right.
I don't want it. So how do we fix it?
Okay.
Because I can guarantee success.
Yeah.
I'll put it in a contract. I can guarantee someone's success if they use guts and they speak to 3, 4, 5 people a day using the gut system. Sir, you have a problem? Sir, is your problem? Ring, ring.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
Yes.
I heard you have a problem.
Well, I have a house I'm trying to sell. Is that what you're talking about? I don't know.
Yeah, how come that beautiful? Yes, sir. I'm sorry. I'm a little. This is our first phone call, sir. My name's Claude. How come that beautiful house on Orchard Lane can't sell in this hot market? What's wrong with it?
You know what? I've been asking myself the same question. I'm not really sure. I wish I knew.
My name's Claude Diamond. Would you like to sell it today, sir?
Sure, absolutely. What's the catch here? Can I sell it today?
No catch, sir. We're either going to do a deal, or you're going to tell me to get lost in one phone call, and I'll never bother you again. Is that a deal?
Yeah, sure. Let's do it.
Can I ask you 2-3 quick questions? You ask me 2 or 3. I'll give you my background references, whatever you want. I'll make you an offer on your property, either cash or terms, and we'll decide we're a good fit. Or you say, Claude, get lost, and I'll send you a little gift, a gift card or something.
Okay. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, I'll do it.
What just happened in about 45 seconds?
You qualified, but you asked me some questions, and you got me interested in having a conversation versus hanging up. And that was a cold call. So
that was a real cold call. What was my opener? I don't even remember. I have a mind map of about 50 different. We call these pattern interrupts, by the way. When you're cold calling with a warm call, we know each other already. There's been a communication and it's easy to open up. But when you're cold calling, and when I say cold calling, I mean calling from Zillow or the MLS or Craigslist. Some other resource where someone has invited you to call.
Yeah.
I don't bother people who don't want to be bothered. I don't have the time and I don't like the rejection. So I've just eliminated that from my whole marketing plan. Gotcha. I don't just speak to people who have invited me or contacted me. So when I'm speaking to a quote unquote lukewarm or cold call, because they advertised, I need to sound different.
Yes.
From my competition, because in the first role play, the amateur sales guy, you wanted to hang up on me in 3 seconds.
That's right. Because I know you're trying to sell me something. You sound like a salesperson. Yeah.
You know what? That doesn't keep Mrs. Diamond happy, because I won't make money if I get that kind of rejection. Gotcha. So I had to invent something we call, it's a psychological trigger. It's called a pattern interrupt.
Gotcha.
I'm going to call you up either with a question or showing vulnerability, tough word, or curiosity, or I'm going to do something I call a shock and awe, a crazy Claude guts move.
Yes.
Ring, ring.
Hi.
What happened?
I'm sorry. What happened? Who is this?
This is Claude Diamond. I apologize. You own that home on Avocado Street, right?
Yes, I do.
How come it expired in the MLS? That's a beautiful home in a nice neighborhood. I looked it up on Google Maps. What's wrong?
That's a very good question. I've been trying to get my agent on the phone to figure that out. I mean, is this about buying my house? Is that what this is about?
Yeah, you know what? Thank you for asking, Stroke. Would you mind if I made you an offer on this house today? I'm looking for a property, an investment home in that neighborhood right now.
Oh, would I mind? Absolutely. Let's do it. Okay. What is it? Okay. Tell me more about that.
Okay. Off the role play.
Yes.
Here's a rule. I got a lot of rules that are in my free book for your listener.
Okay.
It's what are the rules? Perception is reality. What is your perception about me right away? Other than I'm a little outgoing and a little crazy and everything like that. But what is your perception about me?
Well, that you're a buyer. You want to buy my house.
Yes. I'm a hot ticket. Maybe in this crazy world of time wasters, looky-loos, and telemarketers, maybe I finally got a righteous guy in a crazy world.
That's right. And you threw me totally off with the pattern interrupt by just hitting me with, a crazy question. Hey, is this a problem? Hey, is this it's like, what do you mean? I don't know. But we're having a conversation and, we've only got typically maybe 7 seconds or less to be able to grasp my attention to keep it rolling.
I got to grab your attention.
Yeah.
See, when someone comes to you out of left field, you're off balance. You're confused.
That's right.
Do I know this person?
Right. You don't know.
Why are they calling me? Are they my next door neighbor? Is it Joe from work? And when do we treat somebody we know, obviously, different from a total stranger invading our an uninvited guest?
Yeah. We hate the total strangers invading our space. Yeah, 100%.
So I either have to be vulnerable. I need help.
That's right.
I need to shock and awe, or something very important, use familiarity. Ring, ring.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi, is this Rufus?
Yes, this is Rufus. How can I help you?
Rufus, this is Claude. I apologize right up front. I'm sorry it took me so long to get back to you. I got your name and phone number here in front of me. How can I help you?
I don't know. You called me.
You're right. You get a cookie. You're right, as Chris Rock would say. What, it's a post-it with your name. This isn't about real estate, is it?
I do have a house to sell. Is that what you're...
That's it. And it's sold already. And I'm bothering you and wasting your time.
No, actually, it's not sold. I wish it was sold. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, well, would you mind if I asked you two or three real quick questions to make you an offer?
That would be fantastic. Yes.
You're a gentleman. Thank you, sir. Boom. How long did that take?
Less than, what is it, 2 minutes, 1 minute?
This is the million-dollar skill. This is turning chicken shit into chicken salad all day long.
The crazy thing about that is that it's, first of all, it's something that anybody can do, okay? And it's not even, I think probably just learning the openers that you can use, but you're just basically trying to open up the conversation and just talk to the person. And it's right. That's fantastic.
And how much fun was this? I mean, we're smiling. You know what I'm doing. And I'm having so much. Can you imagine smiling on the way to the bank?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And you're not scared to make that kind of a phone call.
Yeah. Rufus, would you do me a favor and fire me, please? What's the worst thing you can say? Hi, just reaching out. ABC Real Estate. Can I have a minute of your time? No. Click.
Yeah, you're getting hung up.
That doesn't make any damn sense to me with that 100% rejection rate. But if I do the right marketing, I either do my warm calls or I do these kind of lukewarm cold calls that are in the marketplace already.
Yeah, yeah.
I can have good. If I can have five adult to adult conversations every day, you know how happy this keeps Mrs. Diamond?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
You want to have the best marriage in the world? Marital advice. We just had our 36th wedding anniversary.
Yeah, yeah. Congratulations, by the way. Congratulations.
Thank you. Make a shitload of money.
Wow. Yeah. And it's easy to do when you're taking this approach like this, because this is completely different than what anybody else is teaching people how to do. First of all,
it works,
and it works.
It works so well. You know my definition of success. You know my definition of success, Rufus.
What's that?
I'm debt free, mortgage free. Got enough. I could have retired 20 years ago. Take everything away from me. Get me one of those. What do they call them? Burner phones and a Walmart chart. So I'm not totally naked. Okay. And get me on a phone, one of those, and let me start calling. I will be a one percenter. In 21 days or less. I used to say 30 days. Now give me 21 days. Wow. Get on the phone. I will be making money. I will find, you know what most people are good at? Finding deals.
Yes.
Sniffing out deals. They just don't know how to negotiate it, offer it, and then monetize it. I could find, if I was dead broke, I could get on the phone. I could find deals, put them in a simple contract, and then call up my friend Rufus Thibodeau. Hello, ring, ring.
Yeah. Hello.
Rufus, Claude Diamond here. Are you in a mood to make a lot of money today?
Yes, Claude. Yeah, absolutely. Let's do it.
I don't think we've ever spoken before. I just found a house in Pasadena, $985,000 with a $1.35 million value. You wouldn't be interested in making about $350,000 today, would you?
Yes, I absolutely would. Yes. How do we do that?
I'm sending you over. You're financially, you're liquid enough to do that deal today. If I can't do the deal because we're involved in too many other transactions, are you liquid enough to do a transaction like that this month? You have 30 days to close.
As a matter of fact, I am. Let's send it over.
Let me send you a prospectus and let's talk in about 1 hour. I'm calling a lot of my investors. I'm going to move this contract today. I'm going to sell it for a very reasonable price to you. And you're going to make the big money. I'm going to make the little money. Does that sound good?
Sounds good to me. Let's do it.
Boom, boom, click. Send you a prospectus, and then I call you up, and then I sell you the con. You want to see the sale? Want to see me go to the bank?
Yeah, let's do it.
Rufus, hey, Mr. Thibodeau, I can call you Rufus, right? I'm Claude.
Yeah, absolutely, Claude. You call me Rufus.
I love that name. I love that name. Is that a New Orleans name, by the way,
Thibodeau? It is a New Orleans name, 100%. Yes.
I thought so.
Yeah.
Best food in the world.
Know it. You know it.
Oh. I'm thinking of the etouffee.
Yep. Oh yeah. Oh, the gumbo. On and on and on.
Oh God, talking about food.
Yes.
Make a note. Mind me to talk to you about the future of gut sales. Gut 6.0. I can demonstrate that too. So I send you what is called a prospectus.
Okay.
It has pictures. It has a little marketing study of the property, what it rents for. Other, it has valuation, an appraisal or something I got derived, so you know the value of it. It also, it has a inspection report. I send you all this in a nice, neat little PDF. You have all the information because I'm going to close you today.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. And I have a number in my head. Okay. And I'm going to call you back. Ring, ring.
Hello.
Hey, Rufus, did you get a chance to look over that prospectus?
I did, man. It's quite a bit of money on that deal. I like it. So
a lot of money on that table. I'm selling this contract today for $52,500.
Okay. That's a little bit higher than what I was expecting. Are you open to working a deal on that, or is that carved in stone?
I'm listening. What are you willing to pay me today to get that contract and make yourself $300,000 plus? This is, by the way, this is a real deal that just happened.
Is that right? Okay. So yeah.
My daughter and I just did this deal in California.
Wow. All right.
This really just happened.
So okay. I don't have the thing right in front of me. Tell me the numbers again. What was the value on it again? That after we have that.
It's estimated conservatively at 1.35. I think it's closer to $1.4 million street value. We have it under contract for 985 with a 30-day close.
Okay. That's a heck of a spread there.
That's a hell of a spread. That's $1 million spread. It's killing me. I can't do it because I got my finger in too many pies right now.
Yeah.
My loss, your gain, or you can tell me to get lost. Don't worry about it. I've got 20 other people to call today, but you and I have never done business and I love expanding my investment, investor platform.
Okay. And what was the number that you're looking for? How much did you say?
$52,500 is my offer. You get 300, I get 50 today. Yeah, I get 50 today.
I would do that deal. Let's do it. I mean, that's no question about that. Yeah.
You were easy.
Yeah.
Man, you were easy.
I'm looking at that spread though, man. I mean, honestly, Claude. Exactly.
I could sell that contract. So all day long. If I was broke, naked Claude has no money, but has a phone, has a system.
Yeah.
I'm good. I'm a bloodhound. I can sniff out deals or motivated sellers. I'm good markets or as we're going slowly into this recession, which I predict, I've already informed my students, and be careful. The next 3 to 6 months, I believe we're going to go into a recession. It's going to be, and I love change because I can make money on the down as well as the up.
Okay. So, all right, but you're still throwing a ton of value out. So let's wrap it up with this. Okay. And you alluded to a couple of things here. So let's say you, for whatever reason, became broke, lost everything, and you had to start over today. So tell me the first, the 2, 3, 4, 5 steps that you would take to get back rolling again.
I'd find people with problems. I'd make phone calls. I'd go to the MLS. I would go to Zillow. I would go to Craigslist. You have to have a certain 3 things you need to be successful.
Okay.
The first, we've talked about 2 of them. You need a marketing program that attracts warm leads, so you're not wasting your time and resources on unproductive, depressing rejection all day long. So you need a marketing system that attracts quality leads, or you need to know you need to know how to find leads. Number 2, you need a gut sales method, something that's modern, contemporary, and understands how people think and breathe. What's their oxygen? So you have to learn how to communicate properly with people so that what do you want them to say about Rufus when they get off the phone?
That he's a great guy and that he's helping me. He's not trying to take my money. He's looking to help me. He's adding me value.
He's a righteous dude. I like him. I feel good about him. Do you ever have those phone calls with people that you think, they're going to give me value. They care about me. They're going to take care of me. They're just not out for a buck, but they have they have character.
Yeah, you like that person. You like them.
Like that person. We love that person, we can't. Nobody reading a damn script ain't going to get you those kind of feelings.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, here, $1 million rule, another rule. I'm giving away too much today.
You're not.
People make immediate business decisions emotionally.
Okay.
They make a decision like that. They only justify that decision academically or intellectually later on.
Okay.
So you do intellectually, you do have to give value for them.
Right.
Okay. You have to give information, but on the immediate, getting that commitment early on, up front, you have to make it so emotional to them. What's more emotional than money, by the way?
Not very much.
Not very much. So I talked, what did I say, 2-3 times in that role play before? $350,000 in this property. I can't do it. You get 300, I get 50. By the way, I got that 50 up front, or I got a partial payment up front, some skin in the game up front with the contract and the balance at the close of escrow. All these things can be manipulated or done through the contract.
Totally.
As far as that's
that was a heck of a spread on that. That's also like, I'm not going to give you a hard time on that. I mean, that was like, yeah, I mean, yeah, that's huge. All right. So you said we had three things. We talked about the marketing system, the gut system, the selling system.
Marketing, got to have the gut sales method. It's simple. It works. You need to put in a little time and practice it so that you can be spontaneous.
Got it.
What do those comedians do with the where they is off the top of their head? Something like that. You've got to learn to be so good. Anything you do repetitiously and practice. That's why I'm so nuts about role playing with my students and practicing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that becomes where they can just think off the top of their head right away. So you have those two things. And the third thing you need to know what the hell you're talking about. You need to have, you need to know the strategies. How do I make money? How do I monetize this deal with this buyer, seller, or investor? What strategy should I use? A lease purchase, a subject to, an owner finance? Or am I going to make them a cash offer? So I go to everybody and I'll say, sir, do you want cash? I can give you cash. I've got cash. I've got people who have cash, but you're going to have to discount your property. If you want, that's at the time value of money. So right. If you want full price, I respect that. I'm not going to argue with you. If you want full price, then I need terms. Whatever we discuss, price or terms, lease purchase, term. When I say terms, I mean they hold their equity. They do owner finance. We do subject to the existing mortgage, or we utilize something called a lease with option. I've written several books, the lease purchase Bible, and several books on this.
Yes.
Okay. So it's all about leverage.
Gotcha.
Can I leverage? Can I control this big, beautiful, expensive, overpriced property? Okay. In Southern California, can I control it by renting it with an option to purchase?
Okay.
And then renting it, turning it into an Airbnb, sublet, sandwich leasing it, renting it to somebody else for more money than I'm paying and get option money and positive cash flow and cash at the close? Or can I do like we did in the role play? Can I just sell you, Rufus, ring, ring, Rufus?
Hello, yes.
Yeah, Rufus, I you probably don't remember me. 6 months ago, you called me, but you're looking for a house, but you're just started a new job and you're building your credit. Are you still looking for a nice house and a good school in the area?
I am actually, yes.
I have a house here. It's $385,000. It's a 3-year rent to own, which means that you can move in it July 1st. You can enjoy this house for 36 months and you can buy it at a fixed price anytime you want. You wouldn't be interested in this, would you?
Absolutely, I would. Do I need to have real good credit for something like this? Or, I mean, what are the terms? Do I need to go to the bank, get a loan, or?
You need reasonable credit. You need to be, good question, by the way. Thank you for bringing it up. You're gainfully employed. You're rebuilding your credit. Okay, so you need reasonable credit. You need a means so we know we're going to get the rent paid on time.
Right.
And you need cash up front. Because this is a $385,000 property. How much would your budget allow you? You need some skin in the game. How much would your budget allow you to put? Can you put $15,000 down up front on this property? And I'll lock you into this deal. And you can buy this home for the next, you can move in it now, enjoy it, check it out. You'll love the neighborhood, good schools. It's near the trolley station. And you can buy it in the next, can you qualify in the next 3 years for a mortgage, sir?
Yeah. In fact, that's why I was talking to a mortgage guy. I needed a couple of years or so to get prepared, but $15,000, I could do that. I thought it was going to have to come up with maybe like 10 or 20% down. Yeah.
It's $15,000 down, non-refundable option consideration that goes towards the purchase price. Yeah, I need that up front today.
Yeah.
And it's $2,200 a month rent. If you pay it on time, take care of the property, you can buy it anytime you want in the next 36 months, and you will get the appreciation that maybe comes with it over the next 3 years.
I love it. Let's just do it.
You can say no to me, sir. Don't worry about it. I've got 20 other people to call today. It's okay to say no to me. You're not allowed to think about it.
I love that. And you know what I love about all of this is that, yes, you need to have the exit strategies. You need to know whether you're going to use a lease option or subject to whatever. But even before you get to all of that, you need to know how to talk to the person and how to have a conversation with them over the phone, to even get to that point. So
how much did I make? It's just somebody else's property. I have a contract for 3 years. I locked in the full purchase price. I gave him the full price. Yes. On the property. Okay. So everybody always says you got to get it under market and beat and get art. You know, people don't want to drop their prices in a hot market. No. I'll give them full price. I just need control. And then I call up my friend, my tenant buyer, Rufus, and I sell him the contract for $15,000. I just, you know, hey, honey, we're going out for a steak dinner tonight.
That's right. I just made 15 grand. Bam.
Yeah.
I love it.
So much fun making money and helping people solve their problems. So much fun.
Well, especially when you have a system so that you can repeat that process over again and you know what you're doing and you're not scared and you're helping people, but you're building your confidence. I mean, I love it. Claude, man, you gave me a 1-2 punch. We got two episodes out of this, two for the price of one. And I appreciate your time. I still don't want I want to still have another opportunity to talk to you at some other point. Is your door still open for me to call you another time?
Anytime. Just we're in Colorado right now. We're in a mountain home. We're in Winter Park, 10,000 feet. We're getting ready to lock up this home, go back to San Diego, our other home. Okay. And if your viewers like episode 1 and 2 and my free book at my webpage, ClaudeDiamond.com, yes. I'd be my pleasure and honor to speak to your audience again.
Okay, we'll do it, Claude. So the best way to get hold of you is to at your website. Again, tell the address again, ClaudeDiamond.com.
ClaudeDiamond.com, or just Google my name, Claude Diamond. Your audience is so intelligent and beautiful. All I got to do is Google me, and they'll find me. I'll even give you my phone number, 970-281-5151. Guess what I also do that nobody else does?
You answer your own phone.
Why doesn't anyone else do that, Rufus?
I don't know. I don't know why they don't. And guess it's what, go ahead.
Guess what happens when you talk to people?
Yeah, you start making money, you make friends, you do deals, you get clients.
You can sell, you can make more money than you'll ever need in a lifetime, and people will gravitate towards you because you're part of the solution, not part of the problem.
Yeah. I've taken way too much of your time. I appreciate it.
No, this is great. Okay, you're a great interviewer, man. Well, let me ramble on.
I learned a lot. I mean, I'm talking to a billionaire. I got to let them talk and I listen. I mean, that's what you got to do. So
talk to people, learn a system.
Yeah.
And that's all. If you can spend time making 5 phone calls a day and talk to people using the gut sales method, you will see, I guarantee this, I will put it in writing, that you will see magic happen.
I love it. Well, let's do it. Gut system rules. We'll talk to you again. Hey, man, have a great weekend. Have a prosperous week. And we'll talk to you real soon. Okay, Claude?
Take care. Thank you so much.
Thanks, man. Talk to you soon. Bye now.